When it comes to colors, the tab you might want to explore is a Materials tab in the default tray. So you either go to Window, Default Tray, Materials, or just scroll down right over here. In the Edit section, you can modify each of the scene materials. You can change its name, its color, and the size of the texture, if there is one. As for color, the case is pretty obvious. You just change the color using any picker. Color wheel is the default, but it is hard to choose bright colors with it. My favorite is HLS, which stands for Hue, Saturation and Lightness. Those three bars change each of them parameters. Hue first. Choose any color you like by moving it around. Then saturation, grayscale, to the left, most vibrant, to the right. Lastly, lightness, black to the left, white to the right. That's how professionals do it, and you might also know it from any Adobe software. As for textures, sadly, it's not that easy. Moving those bars within textured materials won't do anything to the render. We need to use V-Ray to change the color of a texture. Let's go to the Asset Editor, click on Materials icon, the first one, and choose the material we want to edit. Alright, we are looking for a diffuse layer. It's responsible for the color of the material. If the material is simple, like this yellow plastic laundry basket, it responds just like SketchUp does. By changing this little rectangle's color, you can change the overall material. The basic bar lets you choose darker or lighter tint, and when you click on the rectangle, you can just choose the color from the color picker menu. You can see hue, saturation, and lightness parameters analogical to what we have chosen previously in SketchUp Materials tab. But what about the textures again? If the material uses one, like this stone head sculpture does, moving the bar or even changing the color of the rectangle won't do much. That's because this checker is blue, which means there's something in there. It could be anything from simple bitmap to some crazy modifiers. Actually, if you click on that checker, it will show you what's in there. As you can see, it's just a simple bitmap this time. By clicking that blue checker, we went deeper in the hierarchy. So now we don't see the V-Ray material as a whole with its reflections, displacements and all, but we only see the diffuse slot. I hope it's understandable for you guys. To go back, we just click on one of those arrows and we are in the default view again. Understanding the hierarchy is very important. We can go deeper in the hierarchy by right-clicking this blue checker, going to Wrap In, and choosing, let's say, Color Correction Modifier from this menu. It takes you to the editor right away, and as you can see, there are some new bars in here. You already know what hue and saturation does. We can make this sandstone purple if we move the hue bar. It can also be more or less vibrant if we move saturation the right way. You can brighten or darken the texture with Brightness Editor, but be gentle with this one. If you mess up too much, contrast may come in handy. That's how to change the V-Ray material color without any help from Photoshop or any other software. Pretty cool, huh? But let's take a look at that hierarchy in diffuse layer again. Color correction is first, and it has a bitmap wrapped in. So it's a two-step hierarchy. Think of it as of the Inception movie, where there are dreams within dreams, each of them leading to another universum. It's the same with V-Ray. You can wrap that bitmap in a modifier once again to create another step in the hierarchy, but let's stop here, not to make it too complicated for you guys. It's a subject for another tutorial. So, we have changed the color of the texture, bravo! But wait, what happened here? What's that weird-looking texture? Actually, it's texture helper. We used color correction in the first step of diffuse layer, therefore SketchUp got lost. It doesn't know what to put in the viewport because the bitmap that was there previously is gone. It's deeper in the hierarchy, so SketchUp doesn't see it anymore. If we want to revert that nice sandstone in our default view, we need to scroll down to Binding menu, where there's Texture mode. This is the place where you choose how the material is seen in the viewport. By default, it's auto. So the first slot of diffuse layer is superior. Let's change it to custom mode and choose the bitmap we want to see. Or go to our color correction modifier, right click on the input, copy it and paste as instance so it won't make another copy of the texture. There are just a few ways to do that same thing. Ta-da! That's how you should do it, and it applies just the same to any model. Go on and experiment some more with those modifiers and play around with materials hierarchy. You can use ModelUp.co as your training ground. It's a platform with free, very ready models for SketchUp. As you can see, I have used some of them in this tutorial. Anyway, look that up for yourself and also consider subscribing to ModelUp channel where you will find more tips from the SketchUp professionals. See you soon!